All but one game from Week 5 is officially in the books, and there were a lot of big things that happened. Deshaun Watson threw for over 440 yards and 5 touchdowns in a game where the Texans put up 53 points as a team. Will Fuller had 217 yards receiving, which was good for more yards than quarterbacks Lamar Jackson, Carson Wentz, and Daniel Jones threw for. In a game I thought for sure that would be very one-sided, the Raiders surprisingly beat the spread and beat the Bears across the pond. In a very eventful week, there are sure to be things to take away, and that's what I'll discuss in today's video, is some of the biggest takeaways from Week 5. Before I get started though, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as all support is very much appreciated. Now with that being said, let's begin. The first big takeaway from Week 5 is that the Texans' offense is legit. The Texans are 3-2 on the season and should be 4-1, but Deshaun Watson has 3 3-touchdown games through 5, and his passer rating has been above 114 in all 3 of those games. I would love to see the Texans do well in 2019 and make a lot of noise in the playoffs, but I don't know how likely of a reality that is due to their defense, Patrick Mahomes, and Tom Brady. But for now, the Texans are 3-2 and are looking great on the offensive side of the ball. This is all without DeAndre Hopkins being his normal self in the past 4 games, as over the past 4 games he has 23 catches for 236 yards and 0 touchdowns. While that's not bad production by any means, that's definitely not the standards that DeAndre has set for himself and fantasy owners. The Texans look good even with Hopkins not playing up to his own standards. Moving on to the next takeaway is the Buffalo Bills are legit. Through 5 games, the Bills' defense has given up the following point totals: 16, 14, 17, 16, and 7. They've given up 70 points in 5 games, which equals out to 14 per game. Bills Mafia definitely has something to be excited about in their defense, and for good reason. Their only loss through 5 games is to the Patriots, and if it wasn't for a blocked punt, they may be 5-0. They don't play again till Week 7 due to their Week 6 bye, but they play the Dolphins at home, which should definitely put them at 5-1. Josh Allen through 5 games has only 5 passing touchdowns to 7 interceptions and has a passer rating of 75. While he has improved a little bit statistically from year 1 to year 2, he needs to be a game manager type player, and the sky truly is the limit for this team. Josh Allen just can't lose this team games. The Bills only lost to the Patriots by 6 after Allen threw 3 interceptions and had a good chance to win at the end. If Allen can cut down on the turnovers, the Bills can go deep in the playoffs. The motto "defense wins championships" has stood the test of time and was proved last year in a Super Bowl where only 16 points were scored through the course of the entire game. The Bills are for real and can definitely make noise in the AFC. The next takeaway is that Teddy Bridgewater can be a starting NFL quarterback. Teddy Bridgewater is now 3-0 as a starter since taking over for Drew Brees, who was injured in Week 2 against the Rams. While Teddy did not play great against the Cowboys, he did get the win and got another win against the Buccaneers this past week. He had his second career 4 passing touchdown game and threw for over 340 yards as well. In Teddy's 3 starts, his completion percentages in each game has been 70, 77, and 76. For teams that will miss out on quarterbacks in the draft next year, Teddy can definitely be a 1-year rental for quarterback needy teams, if not longer. Not every team will get Alabama quarterback Tua Tagovailoa, and some will definitely miss on getting their guy. Teddy is good enough to not lose games and could definitely help a team make a playoff push. As far as I'm concerned, Teddy is a better starting quarterback than at least a few current teams' quarterbacks that are starting now, and I'll leave that up for interpretation. Moving on to the next takeaway, is Christian McCaffrey is a very, very special talent. Christian McCaffrey in Week 5 against the Jaguars ran for 176 yards and 2 touchdowns, a 9.3 yards per carry. In addition to this, he caught 6 passes for 61 yards and had another touchdown receiving. Christian joined Hall of Fame running back Jim Brown as the only players with at least 175 scrimmage yards in 4 of the team's first 5 games of the year. He has forced 25 missed tackles the last 2 weeks via Pro Football Focus, which is an insane number. That's averaging 12.5 missed tackles per game over the last 2 weeks. There cannot be enough good things said about Run CMC. With Patrick Mahomes having an off last 2 weeks, at least statistically, Christian is forcing himself into the NFL MVP conversation. He is currently on pace for 1,878 rushing yards, 99 catches, and over 890 yards receiving. He is a very special talent, and I hope he remains healthy because he is a very enjoyable player to watch on Sundays and a very good guy to root for. The only negative thing I can say about him is playing against him in fantasy is never a fun time. The next takeaway is the Chiefs are a very beatable team. Despite Patrick Mahomes injuring his ankle during Sunday night's loss to the Colts, this game proved the Chiefs are a very beatable team. For the first time since Week 12 of the 2017 season, the Chiefs were held under 14 total points. The last 2 weeks, Patrick's completion percentage has been below 58% in each game, whereas in his first 3 games, it was above 68% in each game. A player's completion percentage and passer rating usually doesn't drop as significant as Pat's has in the past 2 games, unless something is seriously wrong, and I think it's fair to say that the ankle injury is hurting him more than he would like to admit. The lowest his passer rating in the first 3 games was 131, and over the past 2 games it has been 81 and 91.9, which needless to say for the standards he has put on himself is not very good. The Chiefs aren't beatable just when Patrick isn't himself, but their defense is a huge liability as well, as seen last night by the Colts' ground and pound game. Jacoby Brissett averaged just 5.2 yards per attempt and only threw for 151 yards. He threw an interception to 0 touchdowns, and that was fine because the game plan went through running back Marlon Mack as he carried the ball 29 times for 132 yards in a Colts win. The Colts dominated the time of possession 37 minutes to just 23, and that's definitely a way teams can beat Kansas City. Ground and pound the football and keeping Patrick Mahomes off the field by game plan, not due to injury, as much as possible is the key to beating the Chiefs, and the Colts realized that last night and went into Arrowhead as 10.5 point underdogs and came out victorious. This concerns me for the Chiefs' future because the Patriots can ground and pound the rock as well as anybody in the NFL, and if Kansas City wants to go to the Super Bowl, they're going to have to figure out how to stop the run game before they face Tom and company. That's all I have for today's video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please like the video and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Again, thank you for watching, and have a great day. Skol Vikes.